was locked from the other side. I couldn't get in. I was missing something. This is where they gathered before the play. This is where it began. Reality. Another vision. Another idea.
Why set up a play in a hotel? Why this hotel?
Because the rent is cheap? No. The ocean view was perfect for this. It's said to be haunted. Dark stories about murder, death, suicide. Supposedly, an actual cult once performed an unspeakable ritual to summon something in the ballroom. Did we summon the same thing? Tapped into something horrifying? It seemed like it was part of the play, but it wasn't. Does that sound crazy?
You don't want to ask me about crazy, kid.
A haunted hotel. Yes. That's a trope for a reason. real, all right. I recognize my writer's room on the stage. I almost dreaded the ideas this would conjure up.
Nice set you got here. What was the scene in this room?
Well, this is what we call the writer's room. In the play, it's where the devil rewrites reality whilst God is asleep. The devil was our star role. I got a big-time celebrity to play him, and he was method acting the role to perfection. He never broke character, always wore the cult mask. His name was scratched out on the posters.
Mm-hmm. And who was this mystery celebrity? Let me guess. Alan Wake?
I wish I could tell you. But turns out there were masks upon masks. Whoever he really was, shit got weird when he was around. Some of the crew joked that we'd actually hired the devil to play himself.
Mr. Scratch is the devil. He was born to play the role.
I had to agree with Casey on that. Something out of a horror story, but I had to keep going. This is not my writing. This is Scratch mocking me.
lost the plot! You won't try to get out of my story!
Place, a shifting space, existing in a countless number of parallel realities. Sometimes a quaint small town, sometimes a hulking metropolis. Different every time we set upon the road that leads us there. And yet, like a half-remembered echo of a fading dream, always familiar to us. These are the stories that take place there. More inspiring, macabre, terrifying.
Alan Wake.
This was dark, but the story had to be dark. The Devil's Path up the staircase was draped in blood.
Hardwick.
I felt the presence of a new idea here.
Mr. Scratch, if that's who the actor playing the devil was, had stayed in the hotel. Asking around at reception got me a room number. 666. He had requested that room, specifically. The devil had a sense of humor. Or he really didn't. It was funny either way. According to the director, the actor hadn't mingled with the rest of the cast. He had only come out for the play, and always in character.
Scratch had been here. I could sense his presence lingering in the room. I was about to have another killer idea.
Lady Belkane, let's talk about the Belkane. Let's talk about the murder victim. The lady who was killed in the climax of the play.
The leading lady. Oh, it was an honor to get to work with her. A grand dame for sure. She went back a long time. Kept insisting she had seen the long-lost original script of the play. She'd been with this mysterious writer, his muse. That was her role in the play. The muse.
She was staying in room 108, where the murder happened.
The set of the final scene, right. The devil comes, an unstoppable force crashing through the hotel through each scene, executed with devastating mastery. And all leading up to him, meeting his muse. It turns out he knew her. He'd only joined the play to get to her.
To murder her.
Not you again. Again. Again.
Ha!
The dark presence had come for me, drawn to the story I was writing as it grew darker. Scene had changed.
I've had enough of that freaking gumshoe dick asking too many freaking questions. Not letting us proper police take care of it.
This is our chance to make the powers that be happy. We'll be set for life. Part of the inner circle.
Well, amen to that, partner. I like it. And so the fraternity, the club, the word. Our dear friends with many names. The way I see it, it was a lone nut job. A junkie out of his mind on some fancy new designer drug.
Open and shut case. All we gotta do now is dump the evidence from room 108 in the usual place in the alley.
Thank you.
This was the murder site. There was a record at the bottom of the bathtub, beneath the body. Somehow, it was important. Another step. Somehow, I was closer to home. Closer than ever before. It's you again. The FBI agent. Saga Anderson. I'm closer now. I can feel it. You helped me get closer to escaping.
Meek? Are you still trapped? Yeah, the clicker. We can feel it.
You know about the clicker. It can help us. I destroyed the Dark Presence with it last time. You can help. You can find it. You must find it.
I can get it to you. I have to understand. Did you write down the story?
Alice is in danger. I have to stop Scratch. I have to find Return. I need to get back to my apartment. I'm writing a story to get through. Initiation. It's the only way.
The story.
You can do that, Brad. You can write our
name. It lasted only for a moment, like two planets passing in orbit. Saga Anderson was helping me go deeper, closer to escape. Somehow, I had to trust her. Parliament Tower. I had to get back to my apartment, my study. I had to find the manuscript of Return. Parliament Tower was here, again. Zane said the manuscript of Return was the key to escaping. I had to get it before Scratch did.
for months after Ellen died. I didn't leave the apartment. I was flattened by the confusion, shock.
Alice's work had consumed the apartment.
The guilt.
Her whole life.
Fear. I could barely get out of bed. Barry Wheeler started visiting. He even cooked me meals. I couldn't stand the guy when I first met him, but he's a better friend than I gave him credit for. He still checks in, even after he moved out west. One morning, I saw a deer soar past my bedroom window. It was a balloon of some cartoon animal. And I looked out at the street below, and I saw a little girl crying. Like losing that balloon had just ended her whole world. It was the perfect image. The horror of caring. And that's when I got myself out of bed. And I picked up my camera. There was something in the dark. Something I needed to see. To show. The more shadows I photographed and filmed, the more I felt like I was on the verge of a breakthrough. I submerged myself in it. I only went out at night. My search became obsessive, but I still had no idea what I was looking for. In the shadows. Fear of the dark is really just fear of what could be, that vast, paralyzing ocean. But photography can freeze reality in a snapshot, put a cage around the infinite and capture it. I need to prove those faces are really there.
Thank you.
full manuscript of a novel. Return. A horror story about the dark presence escaping from the dark place, taking over Bright Falls. I couldn't remember writing it. I had not written it. I would never write this. I knew who had. Scratch, a monster with my face. If this story came true, Scratch would get out, people would die. Destroying the manuscript, it wouldn't stop it from happening. I would have to fix it, edit it. I could not change the genre of the story. I'd have to work within the constraints set by Scratch. I needed someone in the story to fight the darkness. Saga Anderson. I kept seeing her in my visions. She was already in Bright Falls, already involved, but she was not in Return. Not yet. I'd write her in, try to stop Scratch within the limits of the horror story. It was almost impossible. It was taking too long. I had not reached the end. Scratch stopped me before I could finish my edits to the manuscript. The memory of my edits was already fading. Terrible things would happen if the manuscript came true. Scratch was there, at Parliament Tower, undoing my work. He could use the story to escape. He could go after Alice. Zane had said we worked on Return together. That was a lie. Scratch wrote Return. I would pay Zane another visit. He had guided me to two murder sites. I needed a new one to get back to Parliament Tower. A new draft of initiation.